Hello students, welcome to Karthikeya IAS Academy, the daily objective practice questions on 6th February 2020. So today we are going to see another important 5 topics on it. The first scheme is what is meant by lead bank scheme, and the second is what is additive manufacturing, and third one is starred questions in the Indian polity, and fourth one is emission gap report, and the fifth one is National Register of Citizen or National Citizens Register. Okay, we'll start the working on it. The first one. See, the first question, consider the following statements with respect to the lead bank scheme. What is meant by lead bank scheme? So, lead bank scheme is a scheme which was started in 1969 to support the rural financing. Rural financing, especially to take as a district as an area approach. Rural financing, which is very difficult in the rural areas, because in the rural areas, when you wanted to go for MSME or priority sectors or especially agriculture, it is very difficult to get the loans. So that is why the Union government in 1969 started a lead bank scheme. So we'll discuss about it. It was introduced during 1991 reforms. Wrong, because it is 1969. Second, it was started by providing adequate banking and credit in rural areas through an area approach with one bank assigned for one area. So this is right. So answer is only 2. Now the answer we'll read it. So the lead bank scheme introduced towards the end of 1969, which envisages the assignment of lead roles to the individual banks, both public and private sector banks, for the districts allotted to them. A bank having a relatively large network of branches in the rural areas to give the responsibility, to take the responsibility to provide such kind of financial assistance, that is to adequate financial assistance. So the lead bank scheme was started for providing adequate banking and credit in rural areas through an area approach. So likewise, it is very easy to understand what is meant by lead bank scheme. It is a scheme implemented by the Union government on area approach, which was started in 1969, especially for providing rural credit or adequate financial resources to the district wise. Second question, the term additive manufacturing is recently in the news. So which of the following? Option A, fruit-based processed food. Fruit-based processed food. Second is 3D printing. And third one is genetic drugs. And the fourth one is defense industrial corridors. So the answer is 3D printing. It's nothing but layer by layer manufacturing. So we'll see it. So the additive manufacturing is an appropriate name to describe the technologies that build 3D objectives by adding layer upon layer of the materials, that is adding one by one, one by one, one by one, and by finally they're making one objective with using of 3D technology. So that is called adding layer by layering, is called additive manufacturing. So simple. Now question is, the term additive manufacturing is associated with which of the following? It's a 3D printing. Very important, sir. Next one, third question. So this is related to Indian constitution or especially polity or especially parliament. The question is with reference to starred question. In the legislature, consider the following statements. Now, if you see the parliament, if you see the parliament agenda or sessions, the morning session will start between 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. And afternoon session will start between 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. This is as you know that. Sorry. But 11 to 1 p.m. what will happen? That is between 11 to 12 o'clock it is a question hour. And between 12 to 1 o'clock is a zero hour. So then this is question hour. What are the questions are going to be asked? In the question hour, there are generally 2 types of questions will be asked. One is starred questions. Second is unstarred question. Second is unstarred questions. So in starred question, the question will be asked in oral form. The questions will be asked in oral form, which will have supplementary questions. That is, they can ask a supplementary question. That is, any member of parliament can ask the minister on first oral questions and supplementary questions. Then unstarred questions will be asked in written form, which will not follow supplementary questions. They won't ask any supplementary questions, only written form. Now see, in starred question, it is one to which a member desires a written answer. Completely wrong. Because it is written, it should be unstarred question. That is, you won't see any star on the question. That's it. Second, such a question may be followed by the supplementary questions, right? So statement is 2, option only 2, right? Thank you. Next, a starred question is 1 to which a member desires an oral answer from the minister in that house, which required a distinguished by him or with him to asterisk. And answer to such question may be followed by the supplementary questions. Very, very important. Generally, 20 starred questions will be asked during the question hour in one day. Are you getting my point, sir? The concept of question hour started in 1972, but generally per day, maximum how many questions can be asked? 20 questions. This is important. Okay, so please read it and understand the concept of question hour is like this. Next, fourth question. With reference to emission gap report, recently you'll see that especially Paris Climate Agreement. So this is an important in the news. Consider the following statement. It is published by UNEP, yes, United Nations Environmental Program. And the report presents the latest data on expected gap in the targets of Paris Agreement, right? So both 1 and 2 are answers, right? So the report represents the latest data of the expected gap in 2030 to be reached by to decrease the 2 degrees of temperature. That is 1.5 degrees to 2 degrees temperature targets of the Paris Agreement. It considers the differential scenarios from now new climatic policies since from 2005 to fulfill the implementation of all the national commitments. That is, all the developed countries and developing countries, they decided to reduce 2 degrees by 2030. 2030, they wanted to make sure that all the temperatures should be reduced to below 2 degrees. Tulo means the standard levels of temperatures. And along with that, so they wanted to come out of the fossil fuels. That is, whatever the fuels which are releasing the emission of carbon dioxide, they wanted to shift from fossil fuels to non-fossil fuels. That is, using of LPGs, etc., etc. So this is the data which we have given. Please read it. United Nations Environmental Program is a flagship program that is called Emissions Gap Report, has been released recently. So important, sir, please read it. Next, final question. With reference to National Register of Citizens, NRC or NCR, anything you can consider, following statement. So NRC is the list of Indian resident and was prepared in 1951. The process of NRC update was taken in Assam as per the Supreme Court orders in 2013, right? So which of the following are correct? So answer both 1 and 2. But actually I mentioned just 2, but it's not all 1 and 2. So the NRC is a list of Indian citizens that was prepared in 1951, which was followed by the census 1951. So NRC update was started in Assam, especially NRC is related to Assam only. Recently Nagaland is also saying that, but NRC is especially for Assam, as per the Supreme Court order in 2013. So in order to wean out the cases of illegal migrants from Bangladesh, we have discussed in the classroom why most of the people came from Bangladesh to Assam and residing there. There is a Naiveli incident case also, we have discussed it. Generally, this NRC is the list of identifying the illegal migrants who came to India, especially after 1971. Okay, sir. With this one, we have completed 5 important questions. Thank you very much.